All right, welcome to another awesome episode of Groovin in Memphis. And boy, we have a groover in the house today by way of the name of Mr. Joel Williams. Hey, Joel, how you doing today?
I'm good, sir. How are you?
I am happy and I'm fantastic and I'm happy that you're here. Now, let me let the people understand something right now. Okay, I was sitting down eating in a Huey's one day and you'll be surprised the magical number of great musicians we have here in this city. And my man, you are one of those people. I was just sitting down eating my steak with my wife and having a good time, and I heard a groover in Memphis, and I said, I got to get him on this show, and I'm so glad you were able to do it.
You're very kind. Thank you.
Okay, so look, let's let them know how awesome that you are. Everybody's driving or either got the headphones on, watching YouTube. Man, let's wake them up. Man, play a good groove for them. Anything you want to play.
Let's see if I can remember what is hip without the rest of it.
Okay.
That's only about the first verse.
Oh, man, what you got in your foot, man? Is it a rabbit in there?
Years and years of foot, that's what's in there.
Wow, well let's talk about the years.
Sure.
And I know you initially grew up in Mississippi. You started in Mississippi, and I think you moved here when you got in high school. Mm-hmm. But how long have you been playing?
I sat down at a drum set the first time about 1962.
Okay.
I was in Whitehaven going to school out there, and mm-hmm. I was in the band.
Okay.
And the guys that I've hung around with were other drummers, and one of them had a drum set. Mm-hmm. And the rest of us had one, but he had one. Mm-hmm. So we went to his house, and we played drums to Pete Fountain Records.
Okay.
Pete Fountain, Jack Sperling. Mm-hmm. And then all of a sudden, the next year, the Beatles came out. And
the Beatles
Pete Fountain was out, the Beatles were in.
Uh-huh.
And from there on, I kept going. I actually played bass for a while because everybody else was a drummer, so I took up bass.
Wow. So and you know the notes.
I know where a couple of them are.
Uh-huh.
But then I got back into drumming again in the late 60s and joined Union and turned pro and kept going.
Well, you are definitely the man, Ed. If you don't mind me asking, what is your age to this day? What are you right now?
I am 72. I'll be 73 in March.
Oh, my God. Did you hear that? 72. So now I need to know the secret, okay? Because I'm 33, right? And you're 72 years old. I need to know the secret of being able to play like this when I turn 72.
You know I got clothes in my closet older than you?
I bet you do. Let me borrow the coat, though. They got some nice coats.
There's no secret. I've tried not to overindulge in all of the things that you can screw up with.
Right.
And I've been fairly successful at that, and just stayed with it. My family has been, my dad lived to 90.
Wow.
And my mother lived to 88, so I figure I'm good till at least in the mid-80s.
Did anybody in your house play music, or your mom and dad? Did they sing?
No, not really. I had an uncle, a great uncle, actually. My grandfather's middle brother was a comedian on Grand Ole Opry.
Wow.
But other than that, no musician or players.
Mm-hmm.
I now have a nephew who is a drummer in Nashville.
Well, let's talk about some of your recordings and let's play through some of them too. I think I saw somewhere you did, you had a band called Caboose.
Yep.
Yeah.
The first name for that band was Butterscotch Caboose.
I like that name better.
That came from, Jim will remember, Strawberry Alarm Clock, and when everybody named bands after flavors. And so we became, we're Butterscotch Caboose and had out a couple of records. We cut over at American, where Elvis did a couple of his albums.
One of my favorite studios in Memphis.
And of course it's not there anymore, the original one over at Thomas and Chelsea. And we cut over there and did a couple of records. Then we moved over to Lynn Lou, which was also on Chelsea, with a guy named Larry Rogers, who is in Nashville now. He's a producer. And recorded with him and had one album out, which was out on Isaac Hayes' label, Enterprise, which was a sub under Stax. And that went out, and it just kind of finally dropped off. I think the single we had out of that got to number 69 in Record World, and that was as close as I got to a record recording fame.
So I switched gears here.
Yeah.
Right? I was sitting down enjoying my meal with my beautiful wife, Jessica, and we love music so much, but we're also students of the music. And I am a fellow groover myself, and I hear a lot of musicians don't take it as seriously as you and I. A lot of them kind of just fly over the notes and everything like that. What are some other songs that you really enjoy to play today?
Pretty much everything. You haven't seen the big band, Memphis Funk and Horns, which is, we're playing Saturday night at Neil's. There's my advertisement for my gig. And there's several new songs we're doing on there, some Earth, Wind, and Fire. Got to Get You Into My Life by them.
Oh, yeah, nice and, shuffle on that.
Yeah, I have to read the, read a lot of that because there's so much going on, but it is, it has got a shuffle. Starts off with, I have to do some this, the beginning of it. And it's find a mic somewhere to get that up close.
You sing any?
Not that anybody wants to hear.
Yeah.
I wish I'd brought my book in here. I could read some of this stuff.
Oh, man. Well, this is what I want you to do is I want us to, you know, pay it forward. I mean, you know, you 72. I'm 33. There's a lot of years in between there. It's some stuff that I just don't know. It's stuff you know that I just don't know. And I want to know. I'm an avid learner. I love to be at the Memphis Jump Shop and just walk into people who can just show me stuff. And you are definitely one of those people.
What are you wanting to learn?
I like the funk. I like funk. I mean, you know, I'm a David Garibaldi fan and Tower Power. I love it all, man. Some James Brown stuff.
We are doing Living in America.
Living in America.
And we're fixing to learn that to where it goes into I Feel Good. Just straight out of the one right into the other. We're doing, there's another one that's. Where he says, give me the bridge, give me the bridge, give me the,
yeah.
Give me the bridge.
Give me the bridge. And I really want to get some of these drum fills you're throwing out here. I mean, you playing some really good grooving drum fills here. Yeah, man, give me the what do you call it? The sweep? The sweep?
Something like that?
Yeah.
The thing I work on that and probably play too much is doubles, like. That Zeppelin tune. Learned that years ago and I've kept with it, but I don't ever play with anybody that wants to play that song. But I still know it.
Yeah, right, right. Don't you hate that? I mean, there are songs that I just listen to from either Buddy Rich or Max Roach or either big band stuff or you know, either funk stuff. And I'm like, man, I'm just looking for people who just know it. I just want to just play it. I used to play with a band called Mo Boogie. I used to kind of just fill in. I get a chance to kind of stretch out and use my imagination. And that was a good time, too. Yeah. But yeah, I mean, I need some of this stuff to go into my database, okay? Because, you know, I'm growing up. You know, I hope to be able to play just as well as you when I'm 72 years old or even beyond. And this is a magical thing for me to be able to see a person really close to me, because I know David Garibaldi is in his 70s as well. Mm-hmm. And I saw him playing just as good, man. And I really like the fact that I have somebody in my hometown right next door and I can say, hey, man, show me this. Just like this right here. Just show me something, and I'm going to try to do my best to emulate what you're playing.
Do you get to play much shuffles? Do any shuffling?
I do a bit. Yeah. A bit.
Because I've got a lot of background in that, and it's I'm not as good as some, but I've got so much time in doing it. Because I've played in a lot of blues bands and played in some country bands, but wind up doing, I mean, shuffle is something that comes up all the time in the South.
Yeah. It's working, man. All right, I'm gonna do what I can.
All right, your
can
turn.
I use your sticks?
Absolutely.
Is that okay?
You bet. I bought them here.
All right, here we go. We're gonna try this.
All right, you'll get graded for this. You realize
okay
that,
yes huh? Okay, are you grading on a curve?
Possibly.
All right,
maybe on an oval.
All right.
Yes, sir.
Was that all right?
You got that nailed.
Yeah. Thank you, Joe.
Thank you.
Well, look, this has been another awesome episode of Groovin' in Memphis with my good friend, Joe Williams. Such an awesome musician. Anything else you want to tell the people about where you're playing, where you know, the bands you play for, where they can find you and everything?
Just two, Memphis Funk and Horns and Memphis Funk.
Okay.
Horns is one, the 9 pieces, and the other one is what you saw the other night, 5 pieces.
Yeah, and they sound absolutely phenomenal. I'm gonna take y'all out of here on that second groove. I'm gonna try to get that one, okay? I'm gonna try to play that one.
Oh, absolutely.
All right, Groovin' in Memphis.